Hello.
Welcome to All Essays. Reach your academic heights. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through Whistleblowing Case Study Essay. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at All Essays. The link is in the description. Whistleblowing definitely is a risky business. Whistleblower is an employee that trusts carefully to the work of the system. When an employee sees something wrong, their natural reaction is to report it. This is often a serious mistake. Some common methods of whistleblowers is ostracism, harassment, spreading rumors, reprimand, removal of sanctions, threats, referrals to psychiatrists, demotion, dismissal, and blacklisting. Damage to the whistleblower is extensive. Many people lost their jobs and have a bill that large economic impact is enormous. Health and public relations problems are common. Many were forced out of their field and are able to start a new career. Retaliation against whistleblowers usually involves an attack on the reputation, working conditions and benefits. Physical attacks are relatively rare. But in some areas, there is a greater risk of attack, frame-ups and prisons, including revelations about police corruption, organized crime, a violation of the military and national security issues. As bioweapons related to national security, to talk about problems and abuses may be particularly at risk. After being a whistleblower, many people lose their relationships at the workplace and also outside work. Therefore, careful and exceptional care is required. Below is an example of the thousands of similar cases. OE on July 22, 2005, Charles Domenezes, having just entered a train, was shot in the head 7 times by London police. The police claimed he was wearing a bulky coat and had jumped over the ticket barrier and had run to the train. But Lena Vandenberg knew the police were lying. She worked for the Independent Police Complaints Commission and had access to evidence presented at the Commission on Registered Trademarks inquiry into the shooting. She leaked information to a television journalist and then was subject to reprisals by the police. In a dawn raid on September 21, 2005, 10 police officers broke down her door and arrested her. She was kept in a cell without access to a lawyer for 8 hours and threatened by police that she could go to prison. She said, "It never crossed my mind that I would be treated as if I was a criminal for telling the truth. Unlike the police, I had an unregistered trademark. He killed an innocent person. Unregistered trademark, Sanderson, 2006. Importance of whistleblowing to counter corruption. Whistleblowers are intrepid, brave, courageous people, confident in themselves, responsible. They unregistered trademark are willing to speak out, stick on values and responsibilities. They are highly idealistic, someone who has the courage to talk about and observe malpractice, idealist, and they have the courage to really stand up for what they believe in. Concerned about the wrongdoings in his or her organization. Can unregistered trademark T stop what unregistered trademark S going on in the organization? People who are concerned do not put so much emphasis in his or her relationships but in the belief that he or she has done something good for the organization by putting a stop to the wrong practices. The aim is to determine which workplace strategies managers should make a priority when encouraging employees to report workplace corruption. Anyone who has blown the whistle of a company or government fraud, waste or abuse, or are thinking about blowing the whistle, or any protesters or trade organizations that promote or encourage whistleblowers need to know the laws governing the protection of information, and there are many laws illegal. But there are also many disadvantages and difficulties to cancel prepared. In the midst of a culture of corporate integrity is the notion that doing the right thing is far more important than maximizing profits. There will never be a system impervious to prevent rogue from doing damage, or to stop the arrogant CEO of abusing officials. But strategies can be developed to promote a culture of corporate integrity which can go a long way to both prevent fraud and strengthen the organization. Now, however, there is no need to worry as the legislatures and courts have created exceptions for those whistleblowers who are at-will employees. Whistleblowers are now protected by statutes and can thus fight any discrimination that an employee might show him in the face of the accusations. Ideal whistleblower protection policies. Federal law prohibits all corporations, including nonprofits, from retaliating against employees who blow the whistle on their employer unregistered trademark as job practices. Additionally, 65 out of 190 countries have witness protection acts, but only 6 of them have whistleblower protection acts, including Iraq, Ghana, Kenya, Japan, Romania, and United States. An ideal whistleblower protection policy should have good internal process for addressing complaints, including a whistleblower protection or anti-retaliation policy to help the organization protect itself from the risk of violating state and federal laws. This policy should afford protections to whistleblowers and can help ensure that if there is a problem, it will be investigated and fixed. Whistleblower protection policies should also include identity of the whistleblower must be kept confidential and must not be revealed to ensure the safety of the person. This is to ensure the safety of the whistleblower from any harm or danger from the alleged individual. Even organizations that do not have paid staff should also put a whistleblower protection policy in place to encourage people to bring their concerns forward without fear of retaliation. Organizations that encourage complaints by having an open door policy create an atmosphere where concerns are considered more transparent. If you saw corruption happening, would you take the risk of being a whistleblower? If I saw corruption happening in the organization I work for, yes, I would take the risk of being a whistleblower. Why? Because corruption is wrong both in the federal and state law. It is also against the work etiquettes. If it is not reported, then everyone in the company might think that it is only way to keep their job performance at the top and could do even severe damage if found out later and affect those who are innocent. I would risk myself to be the whistleblower because I am confident of the protection program will keep my identity as confidential as it can be. References: http://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/whistleblower. http://www.helpline.org.uk/about-us/what-is-whistleblowing/. http://www.northport.com.my/npv2/whistleblowing%20policy.pdf. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about whistleblowing case study essay as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at OWL Essays for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.